To say that Crusader Kings has been a big part of my life would kinda be an understatement. I've spent many hours plotting murders, marrying off family members for power, sacrificing children to dark gods, and in the game, in Crusader. Have you guys noticed that Crusader Kings is probably the game that sounds the worst when you talk about it out of context? Like, you're sitting on the bus talking about what you did in your CK2 playthrough and all of a sudden you're on a watch list? Yeah, it's that kind of game. I was one of many that were really excited when we got to hear the announcement of Crusader Kings 3. But with the game having been out for 8 months now, was it as good as we thought it would be? Was it really a worthy heir to Crusader Kings 2? That's what I want to find out. So today, I, Jarl Koifish, self-proclaimed Viking King and Master of Crusader Kings, will return to both CK2 and CK3 to 100% scientifically compare the two games and answer the question once and for all, who is the real Crusader King? I will be doing a final review at the end of the video, so make sure you watch the whole thing. Subscribe now! All DLC ever released for a monthly fee, $4.99. So the average OnlyFans costs like $15, and instead you can get all of the cool DLC and you're not simping. Sounds like a great deal, to be honest. Crusader Kings 2. Who remembers Crusader Kings 1? Not me, that's for sure. Just like my parents think, the second child is the best child. I'll let you guess if I'm the first or second child. But Crusader Kings 2, wow. When I first started playing the game, I was like, why would you stare at a man for 5 hours, and now I'm like, 5 hours is not enough. I need to conquer Francia now. So without further ado, let's jump into it. Crusader Kings 2 has these cool start dates, but the cool thing about this is that you can start pretty much whenever you want. Now I usually go with the early Middle Ages, complete chaos. Start from the bottom all the way. But to make a fair comparison, we have to start with the earliest start date that also exists in Crusader Kings 3. So we're starting in the Viking Age, my second favorite. Very cool. We'll be playing as my favorite character of them all. That's right, everyone. We are playing as King Björn Ironside. His sides are made of iron. If there's one thing I miss about the Crusader Kings 2 intro screen, it has to be this. Ah, beautiful! We will be playing as King Björn Ironside in both the Crusader Kings 2 and 3 start. To make this as accurate as we possibly can, we will play with Iron Man mode enabled. No cheatsy doodling. Let's go. Here we are in Svithjod. But this map mode makes me feel like I'm rubbing sandpaper all over my eyeballs. Ah! Much, much better. Welcome to Crusader Kings 2, Electric Boogaloo. I have a list of a few things I want to complete. I want to complete the Sons of Lothbrok invasion of Northumberland. Then I want to form the Kingdom of Sweden. Then we do some raiding, and all through we have fun with the roleplay events and some random stuff at the end. It's been a while since I played, but if I remember correctly, we can win this war and then form the Kingdom of Sweden in like no time at all. This strategy is something that I would say is my magnum opus. Back in the day, I could form the Kingdom of Sweden in about 5 years. Don't believe it? Watch my latest Crusader Kings 2 video, where I also happened to become immortal. Very cool. Become King of Sweden. For focus, join the Wolf War. The Warrior Society, added in Holy Fury, is something I really miss in Crusader Kings 2. No concubines, no problem. Invite women, take concubines. Funny and stupid titans, I love it. Let's get a bit more land, shall we? Subjugation, unlimited subjugation. That's about as much overextending as I want to do. Very cool. Fuck it, we'll take the Gotlendinger as well. Up with the troops. Let's see if we can join the Wolf Warriors. Easy, easy. 1st of January. Let's see how quickly we can do it. I'll be on the front lines along with my son. And we disregard our own safety. Just go in there. Take me a little pod. Oh, I love this start. Because you can just do this. That's one man down. Thank you. And we call him into the war. It's all about keeping the momentum. God damn it. I love this game so much. Mostly because I kinda have it down to a science at this point. I played so much of this game. Could just be nostalgia. Now die, you bastard. Björn, you haphazard brute! A shout carries over the plains where I'm fighting a close battle alongside my personal guards. In the distance, I see enemy reinforcement coming. Listen, I begin to my soldiers. You know what we have and they don't? We have each other, goddammit. Friendship is magic. Oh, that's a brony thing. Fucked. To Gotland we go! I captured a Frenchman. Louis. He's a craven and a doctor. I kill him for the wolf warriors. We won the Sons of Lothbrok invasion already. Good on you, man. We didn't really even have to participate. That's great. I'm so glad my brothers could do that on their own, you know? Proud of you. Keep it up. And now for my sneaky little trick. Soldiers down. But wait, why do you still have an army? Vassal troops, baby. Retinues don't count as having your army up. So, unlimited subjugation. Just being able to dish out war goals. New wars declared with your troops up. That kinda feels dirty, but hey, that's life. Since we don't conquer anything new, we just subjugate them. Rise of the Shia. Shia pets. Wow, wow, wee, wow. Bam, wham. Thank you, ma'am. Ah, and how long did that take? Took me about 1 year. Now we can create the Kingdom of Sweden, because we own all of it. We just need a little bit more of the money. It is time to do a little bit of monetary raiding. Where would you go to raid, huh? Would you pillage the coast of England? Would you raid the riches of Arabia? Give me your money! Oh, aggressive leader! Oh, they have the slow fever here. Jesus, we should be careful. There must be some way to get into Venetia. The city might be well defended, but with control over both land and sea, I have a distinct advantage over my opponent. We will do a little bit of trolling. Outstanding! The riches of Venice are endless. So much money. I'm sorry, Erikir, but all you can marry right now is Jews, and I'm not in the market for a Jew just now. Oh my lord, we absolutely demolished it. I love it. And home we sail. Jarl Vagn. Jarl Wagon is arguing with his wife. I will intervene. And he owes me a favor. That's very good. I totally forgot you could talk to China in this game. Who would want to talk to China? Money gained. Remember when I said I could form the Kingdom of Sweden in 5 years or less? Kingdom of Sweden, form. Very cool. Over to stage 2. Offer vassalization. This one little trick is absolutely amazing. Because all of these counts are really close to us. Very good. Very great. It is time to... No, don't say that word, Koifish. Oh, prisoners. Sell them back. Please buy back your people. A prisoner-based economy is a strong economy. Throne the Moaner. What the fuck? What? Why are you called the Moaner? That's it. I'm gonna kill you. And while we do that, we just casually, you know, grow our Viking Empire. Welcome, welcome. Please join. It's gonna be so much fun. And just like that, we have more troops than we can shake a stick at. We killed him, but he knew it was me. Bye-bye. Oh, yeah. You can do this. Making allies actually useful. Who would have known that actual fun game mechanics are really good? I think this requires the raising of a runestone. Let it speak of me. Just carve in my image and make sure it's well endowed. No, my strong bonds with Odin. After all, without Odin, we are no one. The stone has been raised. It's beautiful. I love it. It's a stone. We can force vassalization upon this man. Because I have my reason for taking this area. I have food poisoning. I'm brave, so I just treat me. Ah! He cut off my penis. I'm a eunuch. And I still have food poisoning. Auto stop all plots, please. Murder is now illegal. Come here, you big bastard. I feel better, but my dick is still gone. How about more prisoners than Guantanamo Bay right now? It's not gonna help me one bit, though, because we need to win this war. Give up, you bastard. I'll siege down all of your land. Ta-da! That's a cool symbol. I wonder what that means. Reform the religion. Temporal leadership. Songs of Ragnarok. Warmongering. And what do we do here? Bloodthirsty gods. Blood for the blood god. We have reformed the Germanic faith. I am the Fylkir. I am the ruler. Time for us to sacrifice. Blood for the blood god. Die! The sound of torment. I leave the altar with my clothes still dripping of the blood of my last victim. After having officiated a few sacrificial rites, I have found that my hands are much steadier. My heart is much more impervious to the incoherent pleas of my offering. Now we shall hold the blood games! It is decided, in a few weeks, a great tournament shall be held to honor the gods. After many who will fight, only one will be acclaimed as the chosen of the gods, while the others will be immolated to sate the eternal thirst for blood of our immortal masters. My rival, the mortal. honor. If you win, I let you go. If you lose, he gets no equipment. The crowd roars in approval as another warrior falls to the ground defeated. The weakest contenders have been quickly disposed of, leaving space for the more experienced fighters and blessing the ground of the arena with their blood. He won! My rival, you are free! There might have been a time when the sight of blood unsettled me, or when the wailing of a child could make my dagger quake and fill my mind with dread.
But not any longer. Gods have granted me the fortitude to perform this sacred work. The immortals must be appeased!
Holy shit, what happened? They cut off my dick and I became a bloodthirsty maniac! That certainly got people wanting to buy back their children a lot quicker, knowing that I might sacrifice them at any moment! We've done raiding, we converted our religion to a new one. We did something really random. Now, let's do some conquesting. They left their island unattended. It is only fair that I shall take it then. I have an infection, and my other infection is dead, aka my wife. Not that I need one, because they cut my dick off. I'm dead. I am now Fylkir Björn. Björn 2. That's Venice taken. Very good. And let's see about... There we go. A Viking Venice. Patrician Sterky Spacky Ugly Roundly. I love it! It is time to hold the bloot! Come to the bloot, my friends! Agnar of Middlepod, I have plans for you! You are a very well important guest! Rolf Ralferson, off you go to the Allfather! Halfdan Haraldsson, off you go! And Ragnar, my friend, off you go! And now we celebrate in the great feast hall! Bloot! Successful! We have done all of this. The Lothbrok invasion, beyond Sweden, Norway, most of Denmark, Iceland. We reformed the religion with me at the head of it. We formed the grand Viking commerce houses of Venice. We sacrificed people to the blood gods. So, how many years of gameplay do you think that was? 100? 200? Think again. Make it 11 years. That's insane! Crusader Kings 2 is truly amazing. And this is just me scratching at the surface. You can check any of the Crusader Kings 2 videos I did. Cracking a cold one with the boys, where I play as Finland. The longest coast. What about my legendary playthrough? The Conqueror, where I conquered from here. Everything! The whole world! Savardo! Crusader Kings 2 is still, and always will be, one of my favorite games. Now, let's see if Crusader Kings 3 can do something similar. It's time to play some Crusader Kings 3. Now, it should be said that Crusader Kings 2 has a shit ton of DLC, and it has a lot more patches behind it. Crusader Kings 3, though, has one DLC, but it's very, very good. Biggest change would obviously be that your characters actually look like humans, which is pretty cool. So what are we waiting for? Let's try out Crusader Kings 3. Crusader Kings 3 has two start dates. While Crusader Kings 2, you can start any day you want between 769 AD, 1400, something like that. So there's a lot more options, but some start dates are kind of boring. We are gonna go with the same start we did last time. Björn Ironside. We'll be playing Iron Man mode on normal. Let's go. Here we are. And this map mode doesn't even need anything changed, because it's pretty good as it is. It's the map, but when you get real close, it's not the map. I honestly think that Paradox fixed this because my eyes felt like sandpaper. So thank you, Steven Paradox, creator of Crusader Kings 2 and 3. We need to win the Sons of Lothbrok invasion of Northumberland. And we need to form the Kingdom of Sweden and do some raiding. That's what we did last time. Now, we got a Björn Ironside that's very focused on diplomacy. Not really optimal for conquesting, but you'd be surprised. One of the better sides of Crusader Kings 3 is that you can customize your dude. Fucking hilarious. This man, Chieftain Thorfinn, we're gonna sway you. You're gonna love me. Let's start forming Sweden. Can I do it in 7 years? We are gonna conquer this guy and this guy. And I'll be damned if we don't conquer this guy too. Raise the armies. The sound of the battle drums are banging. Just like I will be banging your mother. That's a bit of trash talk. It's me leading the army. No real man would let anyone else fight for. I mean, I guess that's the concept of soldiers, but... Off we go! Keep fighting. I'm being raided! Stop it! What's this? They sacked it! You bastards, you raided me! It's the fucking fiends! I'm coming for you. I'll kill you. We've captured Karl. Karl is the name of a bunny, of one of my Discord members. If you want to see Karl the bunny, You can join my Discord. Link in the description. As for you, Carl, since you're technically not the bunny, I'm just gonna sacrifice him. Bye-bye! We have swayed him. Now, what if I did this? I send him a gift, and he becomes my vassal. I have completed the Värmland purchase. Very cool! And that's the battle won. Thank you very much. Lovely bit of conquesting. How's the war going here? Decent. Valdemar, you've been executed. I'm sorry. It just happens. Take a concubine. Ingfrister. Jesus Christ, you look like you work at McDonald's. I accept. Stop raiding me! Stop! I'm a Viking! We are the ones who raid you! Not the other way around! And that's another battle won. Thank you! Off to Gotland we go! Now, I need 13. I have 16. I just need a duchy and some more money. Let's go! To battle! Oh yeah! We won! Grimmer, you are hideous! That's a bit hard on him, but he's also dead. Gotta build up that dread, you know. It's all about the branding. I am Jarl Björn Ironside, and I kill people for fun. He's dead! We won the Battle of Northumbria! Despite successfully besieging the settlement of Örebro. Hey, I used to live there. It's a really bad place. A fortification protecting swaths of Greater Nerik. Jarl Hrane has restrained his troops. He spared him. You Western Jöting! That's it, I'm going to conquer you! And thank you, once again. I made the Duchy of Bergslagen, lovely place. And then we need a little bit more money. Now, how do we get money? We could start up a business. But we could also go into the business of stealing other people's money. That's it, you fucking Finns! We're raiding you back! The eagle has landed, and so has my son. He wasn't flying, but he was an imbecile. How does it feel to be counter-raided, you fucking Finn? Oh no, they're actually coming for me. Well, I'll fight you! Fight me! Fight me! The Battle of Turku!
Oh, a friend! Chieftain Ivar!
But we're fighting, no time for friendship!
You love to see it. But Finland is poor as fuck. Very realistic, but not very good for raiding.
No, we're gonna focus on the shores of Holland. It's time to raid!
Maybe the raiding is a bit better in this game, actually.
Is this sea actually real in real life? But then I realized the Dutch took the sea to their land!
Never trust a Dutchman. Never.
Who the fuck are you? You're bringing a child out here? I'm talking to a 4-year-old. King Lothair, please stop sending children to do diplomacy with me. Sorry, 4-year-old. It's like stealing candy from a child. Oh, they're coming for me! Run!
Chieftain Rikulf for Hildursson of Östergötland. Upon returning from a successful raid, every good Norseman knows to sacrifice a little of their gains to the gods. Every good Norse, except Chieftain Rikulf.
Rik means rich in Swedish. And I guess this is how we became it. As the rest of us divide up the spoils, boasting of our best pieces and discussing what we'll give in thanks to good fortune. Thank you, Thor, for not striking me with lightning. I nicked a goblet from a monk, and I'm gonna throw that into the sea. Thank you. I saw no hand of the gods in our raid, my jarl, only my own hands.
If you keep talking like that, you won't have any hands.
You're a blasphemer. With that said though, I am the king of Sweden, and it only took me 4 years. Are you meaning I can make the Kingdom of Sweden even quicker in this game? Now let's see here. Jarl Dog, I give you money. You become my vassal. Wait, I can buy my way to victory? That's actually surprisingly fun. We shall commemorate this by having a grand blood, and we are terribly in debt. Not very cool. Please, come here. Oh, a feast in Örebro. Of course, who wouldn't? I have been feasting in Örebro many times. Welcome to the feast. The grand blood, the gods shall have human sacrifices. The gods shall have. Halstein, you are the sacrifice. To Odin, to Freya, to Njöder. Off you go. Have fun. Enjoy the blood. Little Norwegian, please join the kingdom. It's gonna be great. You're gonna love it. He's been swayed. He's joining the kingdom. Raise everyone as raiders. I know exactly what I can do. Oh, Västergötland. Come, come. Silly Norwegians, I allow you. Yes. The more people that joins, the better. It's like buying into cryptocurrency. But very feudal. A son, little Yngvar. Yngvar Björnsson, son of Björn. Village, village and raid. Oh, ransom. Bye bye, Italians. Give me your fucking gelato right now. Ah, oh, there is something about raiding in this game that just makes it a little bit more interactive, you know? Is it the events? I don't know. It's just very fun. We are stupidly rich. Look what we can do with all that money. Huh? I can use buy people. Look. Oh, you don't want to? You don't want to? I'm sorry. You've been hit by a smooth criminal. You mean I can actually just buy everyone? Is that so? Yeah, it sure looks like it. What about you, you silly ginger? Here, have some money. Give me the land your father worked for. Quickly, men, more money.
And a dynasty legacy. That's great. Let's go with Wanderlust. That's always fun. Little bit of cash to you, sir. And in you go to the kingdom. You won't do it, brother, huh? What if I give you money? Come on, off from the boat. That's more than enough bribing money so we can buy all of Sweden. Join, it's gonna be fun. It's gonna be really fun. You're gonna love it here. We have Taco Tuesday. Och på fredagar, då är det taco baguette. Taco baguette. I'm going insane, but this is honestly so fun. Is there no limit to this? I can just invite everyone to be a vassal? I'm not complaining, it's amazing. The latest work of my vassal, Jalfrane, has become all the rage at the court.
I'm telling you, he writes really good poems.
A poem to me. The mightiest men must leave this earth, no matter what realms they've given at birth. And when their final hour nears, wonder will life echo through the years.
I love it.
Very nice poem, sir. Why don't the boys give each other poems anymore?
He will accept. Welcome, brother.
He's standing like, I had to do it to him.
Snorri Trolli, a dwarf. Snorri Trolli, walking down the street.
Jesus Christ, he's amazing. Dwarf doctor. My vassals love me, mostly because I paid them copious amounts of money. Yeah, no, I'm absolutely vibing with this. I'm gonna raise a runestone.
I'ma do it. Watch me. I formed Sweden. Put it in Uppland.
Very well, it's time to look a bit more west.
Jylland, come on. Yes. Thank you! It's better to be alone, no, with me, than to be alone.
Please, be with me.
Ding dong, the Northmen are here again.
Please, stay, we just got here. It's rude to leave.
You're Björn! You ripped the head of Beothric.
And that's the last of them.
You bastard. Give me your land.
Wow. Koifish, I didn't know you were this good at the game. Well, I might as well take Iceland.
I have to do it, I'm sorry. Normandy beach landing, come here you Vikings.
Jarl Ivar passed away. You can no longer sway him. No, I can't.
Thank you for Iceland. I have died. No.
How bad is it? Not great. Let me see if I can fix this. We'll simply kill my brother.
Bye bye. It is time for you to die. And my little brother, you're dead. The kingdom is united. Very good. An unfortunate accident. Up we go, gentlemen. Hello, we're here. And we're gonna take your land.
I need it for Viking reasons.
Subjugate Finland. Put them under my control, please. Oh, the Battle of Åland. Finlandia. Finlandia. Niet Erikir. It's time for you Finns to realize that there is a new top dog. That dog is me. I eat you. Very close. Very close.
I've died. But I didn't lose anything.
Bada bing, bada boom.
It's time for the final battle.
It is time to be conquered. My wife is my love. I don't have time for love. All I have in my heart is hatred. All my heart has in it is conquest. Imagine getting to go home. The Finns don't even have a home.
And with that, it is time.
King Björn the Second of Sweden will form the Empire of Scandinavia. Long live the High King. Long live the High King.
Well, that's pretty interesting. In 37 years play, I managed to conquer quite a bit of England. Don't look at that. No, don't look at that. That's fake news. I had a great time just inviting people into Sweden. I played at 3 rulers. I did some great raiding. And we kicked some Finnish ass. Very, very cool. Here we are at the end of the video. Time for me to make my final review. Which one is the best out of the two games? Well, with the hindsight of what Paradox learned from Crusader Kings 2, it was obvious that Crusader Kings 3 was going to be more balanced and more fun on launch than Crusader Kings 2. The core gameplay stays roughly the same between the two games, and you still feel like a medieval king or tribal warlord when you rule over your lands with an iron fist. With that said though, Crusader Kings 3 lacks a few of my favorite roleplay functions from Crusader Kings 2, like the artifact system, the supernatural events, and building great works like the pyramids of England. I always felt like there was way more options to do really weird stuff in Crusader Kings 2 than in Crusader Kings 3. That's just what I like to do in the game. So if you don't care about supernatural stuff and just want to have the historical, it won't be a problem. But on the flip side, Crusader Kings 3 completely overhauls the faith system, making reforming your religion amazingly customizable. Just look what this mentally insane Australian did with his tomboy war priests. It's amazing! Though, roleplay-wise, Crusader Kings 3 really has one thing going for it, and that's the character models. Being so animated and expressive, it really makes roleplaying a whole lot more fun in Crusader Kings 3. Every character actually feels unique, and the detail of having some traits change the physical appearance of your character is a very nice touch. I could sit here and discuss all the gameplay changes and the balance between the games, how the retinues work, how the combat system have been changed, but I think the sum of the cardamom is that Crusader Kings 2 just has a lot more time, patches and DLC to back it up. And with some time, all of the features that I know and love from Crusader Kings 2 will find their way into Crusader Kings 3 and be even better. So, in my opinion, which game do I think is the best? I'll still have to say Crusader Kings 2. But probably not for long, as more content and DLC will be added to Crusader Kings 3, making it everything we ever wanted it to be. But tell me, are my opinions completely trash? Tell me down in the comments, I love to hear what you think. This has been Koifish, hope to see you guys in the next video. Until then, stay Crusader Kings, my dudes. Yeet!